as I was at the time. So you're trying to get your reality straightened out and just kind of moving chaos all around you. And I remember meeting with a psychiatrist and talking about maybe about 20 minutes every few days or something like that. There'd be group therapy. I remember they just kept putting in all these different drugs. They would have me try this drug, this pill, that pill. And they would say, oh, this is going to help you. And I got to tell you, they did absolutely nothing. If anything, it just sort of destroyed my reality even more.
Make it worse.
Oh, yeah. I mean, there were times I remember I turned my head to look in a different direction. The scene would shift and kick a wall and catch up.
Oh, jeez.
This is where I was. There were times I remember 8 hours where I had no memories of all that I heard.
Did it stop the voices at all?
Absolutely not. Absolutely not. So, what I was feeling was more like, I call very strong thoughts. It wasn't quite outside, but it was like a voice that sounded very much like my head. And it seemed to sound like my own voice. About 48 hours, I was asleep, but I was hearing voices in the left and right, auditory hallucinations. It was probably men, women, and children's voices. I don't know if we're talking about me specifically, because I really wasn't trying to pay attention to my, I kind of was almost in a state of split mind with all this. The scientist in me was kind of saying, okay, what's going on here? I take abnormal psychology, general psychology, comparative psychology, and college, so I can't believe about this stuff. And here was, I'm encountering this stuff, so I can put it in schizophrenia, major schizophrenic disorder, what it meant and what it entailed. And I remember the brothers 48 hours of sleeping, and I'm to a movie or you're attending a play before the show actually starts. Everybody's had their own little private conversations going on. It's kind of loud. Everybody's talking back and forth. That's what it was like. All these conversations were going on, and I was hearing them. But I tried not to. I tried to distance myself from them. I wasn't like listening to what they were saying. I wasn't sure that they were just talking. And I remember several times in the hospital, they asked me if there were voices or if there were voices. Most of the time, I kind of said no. I think one time I said, I hear sound, but just because I'm dream lights are not sleeping well, so it's probably a great dream lights state. Now, I think you probably count all the counters that just have to fall asleep. Also, you're aware of the voice, like an auditory hallucination out of the blue. And it should happen with everything, but, you know, schizophrenic conditions, it happens a lot, all the time. You hear different voices back.
You tell them and they increase your meds.
Yeah, so I wasn't telling them I wasn't hearing voices and stuff. Well, they can miss what my name was at the time, but I was getting pissed off at them. It's like, why do you got like, my name is, why did you ask me what my name is? And it took a lot of regret. They would ask my name to say my job. They would ask my name to say my life, what it was, to see what I was on, and then disassociate myself. And I think about 3 or 4 weeks in the hospital. That's why they keep asking my name every 20 minutes or so. So, you do therapy on all sorts of drugs. There were some nurses there, I felt they were trying to help me feel better. He was a psychiatrist, he was helpful, I felt like. His approach was to try to get you as angry as possible, to kind of put you down and command you. And I'm sorry, this was the last thing you needed. You want a little bit of compassion to turn upside down. And Jerry talked about how the police were excited. I'm a patient one night, two police officers, and they ended up tying this guy down on the floor in the room. And now there's no doors on any of the rooms that you're in, because the person's having to walk by, make the rounds, make sure everything's okay. And there's one patient that got in.
Come on, Bonnie. Eyes, mouth.
And I realized that they tell other patients and staff that stop drivers. And actually, police came in and found Timmy's there. They cornered him off to another location. I don't know where they took him.
Real quick, if you don't mind. Well, there you go. That'll set up right. I have a question. One of the psychiatrists actually planned to fight. I'm taking this. It's high security. It's a standard point.
Yeah.
You go to a psychiatrist's office.